Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper. Today, a question sent in by Michael from Shanghai, China. Michael is a big fan of pivot tables, and he has a pivot table where he has months down the left-hand side and customer up in the page filter. And so, when he chooses a customer that's bought something every month, of course, he gets all 12 months. But then, if he chooses a customer who's only an occasional customer, they show up only for the months where they have data. And he says, this is really frustrating. He's even gone through and added dummy data, so that way every customer would at least have a zero in every month. And there's actually a very bizarre way to solve this. You need to go to that month field, select one of the months, and then look for the field settings icon. Now, in Excel 2007, it's on the Options tab. In Excel 2003, it's on the Pivot Table toolbar. It's just this little icon here, the spreadsheet with the blue eye. Click that Field Settings, and we're looking for something called Show Items with No Data. In Excel 2007, it's on the second tab. I think in Excel 2003, it was back on the first tab, but it still said Show Items with No Data. Click OK, and then what we're going to get is we're going to see every month, every time. Now, you see that we get the blank cells, of course, so right-click, Table Options, and for empty cells, Show Zero. Make sure that you get zeros there. A little annoying that it's adding this data before January 1st, 2008. Not sure what's up with that. Well, I must have one record in the data set that goes back that early. You can always go in and uncheck those if they are showing up in your data set and get back to a nice report that we can easily change to another customer and see all of the months all of the time. So, there you go. Thanks to Michael for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.